My name's Owen Woodcock, and I also refute some of the things that Henry has said. Henry stated that the trade-offs for planetary space exploration are negatively affecting society. He mentioned that there's a lot of issues addressing monetary expenditures and the well-being of astronauts. I wanted to address that monetary expenditures on these projects have been decreasing since 1966 and have remained fairly consistent. They have remained at about 0.5% of the entire federal budget, which is a lot less than many other projects. And it hasn't increased since 1966, it has remained constant. And regarding the well-being of astronauts, although there are issues with astronauts in outer space, as they spend more time in outer space, their bones weaken and they experience problems like that. These astronauts are well trained. They know ahead of time what the risks are, and it is their choice to go into space and go through these risks. And the more we've gone in these missions, the more we learn from them, and we're able to actually address those problems. Another claim was made that the government is giving too much money to space exploration. I thought this was a little similar to the first one. There's no more money given to space exploration. It hasn't increased. It's remained constant. If anything, it's only been decreasing. Another point that was made was NASA should seek other means to raise money for exploring space. One of the suggestions was that it should fall into the private sector with companies such as SpaceX, and that we should worry about domestic issues. Addressing the private sectors, there's two things that go on with that. The first is that debris was mentioned as a problem. It was said that there was a lot of debris in the atmosphere, and that this could cause problems to other space missions or to us, as they could possibly fall. Something that's what SpaceX wants to do is make tourism out of space flights. So if this is the suggestion to fix that problem, it's not a suggestion to fix the problem, but if it's suggested that SpaceX should be allowed to do this, then it would only make the debris problem a lot bigger, because with more tourism or with flights being in outer space, this would only worsen the situation of debris. And on the issue of debris, according to space.com, the dots are not to scale. There is a lot of debris out in space. It was said that there was 28,000 pieces, but these pieces are small, and the chances of you being there, as of right now, there hasn't been any injuries or any incidents with space debris. And since space overall is so large, the chances of you being hurt by this they're minimal. Regarding school education, it was said that when we fund programs such as space exploration, then schools receive less money, or it is money that could go towards schools. What is important to note is that schools have had budget cuts, but along with schools, so has NASA. They've been on same terms as schools get budget cuts, so does NASA. So it doesn't seem logical to further have budget cuts on these missions if both have been having budget cuts. Not only does space exploration is fundamental to education because it inspires young kids into becoming engineers, into becoming scientists. A lot of people tend to think that out of having a man land on the moon, we didn't gain much from it aside from having prestige. But it is important to note that because of this, there was a lot of kids that when they saw this, they become inspired by it. They looked at the future. They thought of the possibilities of becoming astronauts themselves, scientists, which means that if education is a problem and the well-being of kids through the K through 12 is important, then by reducing funds in NASA and space exploration, we are not helping this situation out. Okay. NASA creates a lot of jobs. Although most of what is being done is in another planet or in outer space, most of the work that is being done is actually here on Earth with many people who have to work to get these missions going. They provide a lot of jobs. Just on the Mars landing, 700 jobs were created, and the budget for this was $2.5 billion, but it created a lot of jobs. Well, it was also mentioned that...
Yes.